Yeah, it was the other Matrix game. Hi, everybody. The other Matrix game had this hacking minigame thing. It was like a puzzle sort of thing where you would... I played it on GameCube, and I think I manually had to type words in. It was like a text adventure. There were different commands you could use, and you had to manually type them in if you're on a GameCube controller. But I did the whole thing. Enter the Matrix is okay. Angry Comics, thank you for stepping up. Welcome to Pizza Party. Yeah, Animatrix game would have been sick. I saw the second two Matrix movies in theaters, but the first one was already on DVD by the time I was aware of it. Slug, I haven't touched my guitar in, like, legitimately 4 years, but I have a, I bought my friend's a blackout Telecaster. It's been hanging by its neck for a few years now. I don't know if it's in good shape. I don't think that's a good way to long-term store a guitar.
Whoopsies.
Sorry, I don't want to get DNCA'd for Rob Zombie, but that song fucking rules. Oh, hey, Libby! Libby, I listen to this song pretty often. Not this one, but the, Dragula. This song was in, Shit, sorry, hang on. Reset brain here, back up. Roll backwards. Dragula. Dragula was already in the Matrix. It was in the background of the club scene where Neo goes to meet Trinity. It's the it's like this the Super Beast remix or something like that, I think it's called. Harry, thank you for stepping back up. Welcome to Pizza Party. And Spires Ghost subscribed as well. Thank you, Spires. What is it, Dragula? Dragula, it's like a drag racer. It's like a drag racing car that's also like a Dracula. Is it really the name of the car from Munsters? That wouldn't be surprising. I know that he's directing, Rob Zombie's directing the Munsters movie. Mothra, thank you for stepping back up. Yeah, we're going to get into Matrix pretty soon here. I think we're just about ready.
Yee.
Angel, Beat, Flight. Welcome back to the pizza party. Captain Bears for Hands. Thank you. Uh-oh. Hype train incoming. Hold on. Go off. Orb, thank you so much for gifting those subs to the channel. Lustrous Orb gifted, it looks like, what is that? How many is that? That's 5 to the channel. Rob Clever Pig, Airworm, Comita, Huge Rooster, Pat Peas, thank you so much. And thank you to Captain Bears for Hands for getting the hype train rolling. Let that shit drop. Too fast. Hang on. There we go. Yes! Get it. Yee! Fuck yeah. Rip it up. Get that shit. Fuck yeah. Fuck. We should start streaming, I guess. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Thursday night stream. I am Patrick. I will be your host for the stream tonight. Get these levels good. Thank you. Hang on. I need a couple shout-outs here real quick. Thank you for the bits, Bears for Hands. Cinnamon Shakes has set back up for 21 whole months. Hazel Bunny dropped 100 bits. Corgo. Patient Overshirt subbed up for 2 months. Welcome back. Killapants is also resubbed. And Patient Overshirt gifted a couple subs to the channel. Those went to Wizard Vapes, Cuttlefish, Leopold the Gloom. And yeah, that's great. And Elsia, yeah, thank you. Welcome back. Well, let me go about some business here. Stand by. Messing. Go ahead and have to turn that down a bit. There we go. Welcome to the Matrix. It's Neil. That's Neil. I really did think his Neil. His name was Neil the first time I saw the Matrix film over at a friend's house. I went over there, and it was already at the conclusion because I got there late or something, and I guess he was just in the habit of watching his Matrix DVDs pretty often. So yeah, he was already at the end of it. It was at the scene where it was the subway fight with Agent Smith and Neo, and it was the moment of sort of self-actualization where Neo insists that his name is not Mr. Anderson, right? His name is the name he has chosen for himself. So he says, "My name is Neo." And I didn't know that his name was Neo. I thought he was like, I legitimately thought the line was like, "My name is Neil." Which is like a bad cathartic line. You have a friend named Neil? That's sick. Neo Patrick Harris. Good one. All right, let's check this game out. I did not play this one. I played the predecessor.
Just like a ball.
Thank you, Minmo. I played the predecessor to this game, which was just called Enter the Matrix. And it was okay. So Enter the Matrix was a companion game to the Matrix films that filled in some of the gaps in the Matrix 2 and 3. You played as Nairobi and Ghost, Jada Pinkett Smith, and another actor whose name I forget. And they were actually in the film as sort of like background characters. And so that game was all about like filling out their story. Yeah, and I played it when I was like 14, like 13. But the Wachowskis were super into like cross media stuff. And like were super dedicated to their gamers, so that they really wanted the games to be good. So they put a bunch of resources and effort into it. Let's start a new save. Good move, Sylph. Uh oh. Got that level 4 hyped train. Thank you for that. So then this game came out a year or two later, and this is the one that I did not play. This is The Path of Neo, which is like a recapping and expansion of Neo's story over the course of the games. Or, sorry, movies. Okay, yeah, I've seen the theories about Morpheus's death in The Matrix Online being the reason he's not in the movie, but again, like, the whole premise of The Matrix shit is just that, like, nobody knows what reality is, so there are infinite explanations for everything that's in that trailer. All right, chat, what do we do? Here we go.
Perhaps I was wrong about you, Neo. I'm sorry you won't be joining us.
Well, thanks, everybody. That's the stream. Have a lovely night. We'll catch you back here on Sunday. Vaya con Dios. And, yeah, just have a really nice day. Bye, everybody. Good thing I hit the stop streaming button before I did any talking. So now I can just enjoy this game by myself, and I don't have to worry about anybody watching me or telling me anything about it. Yeah, it's time for some Pat time. It's nice. It's nice to have the pressure off and just to be gaming for myself. Stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Well,
perhaps I was wrong about you, Neo. I'm sorry you won't be joining us.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the stream. We're gonna play the Matrix. Yeah, welcome, Cinnamon. You haven't missed anything. Uh-oh! Shrek Apologist going off, gifting subs to Clerica Berica, My Cat Kevin, Larkbus, Moonstura, and one cool dud. Also, Comfy Bogart. Thank you for subbing up. Comfy Bogart, that's a cute name. I like that. Pimp mode. Pimpy. Thank you, Shrek Apologist. Thank you very much. What's the best Keanu Reeves movie? That's a great question. Very good question. John Wick is extremely good. The story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the right All right, everybody ready? Okay, oh, hang on. So yeah, we didn't get this prompt before. This is helpful. Okay, so we select with...
The choice is yours, Neil.
I get it now. Okay, that's okay. We're actually going to play it this time. The Matrix is fucking cool, everybody.
You take the blue pen, the story.
Yep. I know. Yeah.
You stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes.
These effects rule.
Have you ever had a dream you were so sure it was real?
These effects are really cool. Yeah, look at us now. We made it. Look how far we've come. So confusing to the eyes. So many effects going at once. All right, this is Neil. This fucking Goosebumps theme.
Viewers, beware. You're in for a scare.
Get his ass. All right. What's that? Doom Church. Thank you for stepping up. Oh boy, they're whooping me. Oh, fuck him up. Yes. I do remember the elevator level of Perfect Dark. It was really cool. Don't threaten me with a good time. Oh boy, they're fucking me right up, huh? I just found a grab button. Oh shit, they killed me. Alright, yeah, let's do normal. Dropkick, I was literally thinking about doing the bullet time deep dive yesterday when the trailer was coming out. So yeah, that might be a thing in the future. Sin Shakes, thank you for gifting that sub to Libby Watson. I'd want to go back into the old, the DVD special features for The Matrix. I forget the name of the guy, I think it was, Gaida, something Gaida, the guy who built the bullet time rig for them. He's a really interesting guy. I remember being young and watching this freaky little special effects guy talk about his camera effects, but he had this awesome bomber jacket on that was just covered in patches. He was speaking American, and he had an American accent in the effects that I saw, Nicholas. The question that brought you here.
What is the Matrix? We'll need a search run.
I've been looking for you, Neo.
You're in danger.
What the hell do they want from me?
I don't know, but if you don't want to find out, I suggest you get out of there.
No.
I can guide you, but you must do exactly as I say.
Remember, do exactly as I say. The cubicle across from you is empty. Go.
That's
now.
His name, Ethan John Gaeta. Ding, 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 ding. This is sick. Okay, cool.
Hide against the cube wall.
Good one, Brandon.
When I tell you, go to the end of the row and wait for my instruction. Stay as low as you can.
Shit. This part rules because in the movie, like, he thought they're just after him for hacking or tax evasion or whatever. But which way? Which way, though? Where am I going? Use your knife to slit his throat, Neo.
Move into the empty cubicle across from you.
I remember this from the movie.
We've
Fuck.
Subject sighted. You're playing with us. You're busted.
Damn, that's it. He works at a software company, right?
Go now. Hide against the cube wall. When I tell you, go to the end of the row and wait for my instruction. Stay as low as you can.
Right, and he sells pirated software to that guy. That cool guy shows up at his door. Oop.
Go now.
And Neo's like, you ever get the feeling like your reality isn't real? And the guy's like, all the time, man. It's called mescaline.
Wait.
Only way to fly. What's the matter, man? You look even paler than usual. At this part in the movie, he is actually squatting this much. Yeah, it's a great question there from Angry Comics. What would everybody's Matrix name be?
Hmm? Follow the officer down the hall.
Dropkick. Yeah, that one's locked and loaded. You got that one. Okay. Dive roll? Really? Asperity, wave dash. Wave dash, that one's good.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be in his shoes when those suits get hold of him.
I hear that. I'm going to search these halls. Stay here.
Someone's approaching from the opposite.
Mine would be Computer Steve.
Around the corner. Stay close to the desk. There is an open fire cabinet behind her desk.
What are you doing?
Hide.
I want you to meet Mouse, Tank, Trinity, and Computer Steve.
How may I direct your call? One moment, please. Agent Brown on line 2.
Damn agents. Hold my calls. I'll be back in a few.
Strike? What?
Go now.
He's over here!
It's Anderson.
This part's so scary. Oh shit, dude. Don't do that. That is not what you do at this part of the movie. You guys scoot along the wall, right? It is funny that they made this part of the game early on where you're just super pathetic and useless. I'm not convinced that Lawrence Fishburne is not going to be in the movie, unless it has been confirmed that Lawrence Fishburne is not in the Matrix, the new Matrix movie. I think they're just saving a little special treat for us. Real player, that's a sick one, Libby. Has been confirmed. Well, shit. Oh, Neil. Yeah, you. If this is like the last Matrix game, you do get access to bullet time. And I think in the other game, it was sort of like a turbo button. A sort of context sensitive. Oh, shit.
Stop where you are!
It was a sort of context sensitive turbo button. So, like, if you used it while you had a gun out, you'd go into, like, slow motion. And if you used it, like, if you were punching, you would do, like, a stronger version of a punch. Is that good? Last I checked, the Matrix movies were on HBO Max in the United States. But I don't know. You're in Australia, right? I know that the distribution rights are pretty much different everywhere. Uh-oh. Yeah, they did not spend this much time on the scaffolding in the in the film. Oh shit. Legs shattered. Right, here we go. NB Britt says, I think the original Matrix is on Australian Netflix. I am really curious. I'm super curious what the new Matrix movie is going to be all about. It looks interesting. All right, get up there. All three are on UK Netflix right now, says Super Bento. Thank you. Yeah, Michael Soft, I did pick up Sense8 vibes. Oh, I didn't do that.
Get over here into the lift so you don't fall. Can you take me up to the roof? Just need to get to the roof.
Sure. Are you okay, buddy?
Yes, I just need to get up to the roof, please.
Stop where you are.
You're gonna knock another guy off this fucking building. So do I just go right up to... Oh, okay.
Jump, buddy. Jump.
I like this helpful guy. This guy rules.
Take her back to the roof. Hurry. Go, go, go.
We're gonna get out of here.
He's up here somewhere. Spread out.
Come on, boy. Let's move.
Don't look behind that door you just went through. I need to watch the new Bill and Ted. Eat shit.
There he is.
Fuck off. Fuck you.
You're going down.
No, you're going down. I know a person called Keanu. Alright, that seems like it's locked.
Back in a minute.
That guy's taking his shit. Okay, that guy's taking his shit. Gotta do our little stealth waddle around this office. Am I back here? What the frig? Oh wait, no, this is a different reception area, I guess. Also, I love the NVIDIA logos all over this place.
About that time.
Oh yeah.
You ain't got shit. No! Clusterfunk, thank you for subbing back up. God damn it. You can accept capture. That's interesting. I mean, he does get captured canonically in the scene, right? Fuck you, dude. Fuck you, man. Oh, right, yeah, he doesn't even make it off the roof. He's too scared to do all that, all this shit. He just immediately goes back inside and they arrest him. Yeah, you're right. This is actually exactly what Keanu runs around like in that scene in the movie, too.
About that time?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Good one, meme shark. Oh, that shit again. All right. Checkpoint saved. Checkpoint.
In a hurry to meet someone, Mr. Anderson.
That does not sound like
what?
Hugo Weaving.
A moment of your time.
I'm not going anywhere with you.
I'm gonna run away. But which way? Where do I run to? Find another stairwell. Okay. No, that's not one. Get off the wall. It's fucking stun locked. I'm fucking stun locked in this animation here. Get off me, dude. Eat shit.
Don't move, Mr. Anderson.
Fuck, no. We're gonna keep trying. We're gonna get out of here. It is really funny how he stops and just keeps crouching, looking right at him.
What do you want? A moment of your time.
A moment of your time.
I'm not going anywhere with you.
Sounds more like the G-Man than Agent Smith. Uh-oh. Ah, it's a dead end. Fuck off, dude. Camera's not very good in this game.
There he is. I see him.
Fuck off. Dickweed. Does anybody call anybody dickweed in the Matrix?
Stop. Don't move,
Mr. Anderson.
Stop, damn it.
Freeze.
Oh!
We're not going to let that happen again.
There he is. I see him. Don't move.
Droop to the left.
Mr. Anderson.
I love it when that guy trips like that. That's so funny.
Stop, damn it.
Yes, there she is.
I imagine right now feeling a bit like us, tumbling down the rabbit hole. You can see that. Have you ever had a dream that you were so sure?
Meme Shark, Keanu doesn't do that shit. You've seen the photos.
How would you know the difference between the dream and the real? This isn't real. What is real? How do you define real?
He does sell motorcycles, that's true.
Feel, smell, taste, see, and real is simply electrical signals interpreted by your brain.
Whoa.
Watching some behind the scenes clips of Wu-Ping training with Keanu and the whole cast training with Keanu and Carrie and Lawrence for the original Matrix, and holy shit, Lawrence Fishburne was in insane shape for the original Matrix. Like, he was straight up just like doing like round offs and handsprings on a training mat. Nice. I always thought that barf looked funny. Yeah, the dojo scene.
What are you trying to tell me? That I can dodge bullets? I'm
trying to tell you that when you're ready, you won't have to. It's impressive.
For what?
Now hold on. What the fuck?
High road, Neil. How's the signal?
It's a little loud. Is this better?
Where am I?
This, my friend, is a series of combat training simulations.
And this is going to teach me kung fu.
Works like a video game tutorial. You do still claim to be the ultimate gamer, right? See that guard? Take him out quietly so the others aren't alerted.
You want me to kill him?
It's not real. Just pretend he's your old boss. My friend, you are a natural.
I killed that guy really good, huh?
Almost forgot. I'll be monitoring your health level. Hit, you can recover some of your health by avoiding additional damage. Take too much damage, and I'm pulling the plug.
So I'm running around an old-timey mine dressed like a ninja.
I'll download new skills as you progress. Keep practicing silent takedowns for now.
Got his ass. Jogs up behind you and does this. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. This rules, actually. The fact that they're, like, doing, like, the Enter the Dragon music.
Give the soldiers a strike combo. Now would be a good time to drive through the enemy strikes with your own.
Okay. Three-hit combo. Drive through enemies. Two-hit combo.
One more thing. I've hidden useful items in some of these crates. Crack open the crates to find them.
Crates? How original.
Fuck yeah.
Cactus makes perfect.
Counter-strike. If an enemy leads with a punch or kick, press triangle to block and follow up with a combo of your own. Okay. Sick. Okay.
Now, let's cause some real pain.
Strong attack. Press that to stun an enemy, then quickly tip towards your opponent. Judo, oh shit, okay. Throw, press circle to stun an enemy, then quickly tip this to the right, or away, right, left, or away from the enemy to throw the enemy in that direction. Okay. I remember this being one of the big, like, talking points for both this game and Enter the Matrix. Had a really good multi-directional attack system, so, like, if you tilted the stick a different direction mid-combo, there was, a bespoke animation for turning around and doing the attack in that direction. God, the run animation is so good.
Come on, man. I need you to keep moving.
I'm moving. Is this where I came from? Yeah. How's everybody's Thursday going? Sorry, I haven't been paying a lot of attention to the chat. For some reason, like, I think the fact that this is a new game that I have never played means I get to look over there a little bit less. Which is wild, because like Dark Souls is way, way, way harder than this, but I think I just have it so deeply ingrained in my muscle memory that I can just constantly look both directions.
What's with the outfit?
Oh, that? I don't know. I think it fits the scene. You don't like it?
It's totally jacked in. Yeah, you're right.
You can sneak into that control booth without triggering an alarm. I'll place a bonus weapon in the next area.
Oh, baby. This is literally the control room from Enter the Dragon in the underground dojo area. Alright, how do I... Or in the underground, like, the area where they're, like, processing drugs and, like, torturing people in Enter the Dragon. Same exact little control room. Strikes counter throws if an enemy attempts to throw, punch them.
If these soldiers stun you, they'll go for a throw, so watch your back.
How about that weapon?
Weapon placed. We'll find it near the end of this training program.
Score for Ninja Crisis.
Yeah. This combat system is not great. Doesn't feel great. It's okay. Doesn't feel great.
Final test is loaded. You'll find it up one floor level. Use the ladder to get there.
Okay. Shut the fuck up. Fuck. Jump strike. Press X and then button. Oh, yeah. Melee weapons open up new attacks and increase your damage output. Most melee weapons break after extended use. However, some weapons have improved durability and attack power. So what do I have? I got a... Is this a piece of wood? You just give me a little fucking piece of wood?
Okay, Neil. Okay. Ready for the big finale. Last man standing wins.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Okay. Link-up attacks. Press circle to stun an enemy, then tip towards a second enemy and press circle and then triangle to attack two enemies at once. This is just a piece of bamboo, I think, I'm hitting him with. Get fucked!
Good, but you're faster.
Alright, you've achieved a greater level of awareness. Focus meter extended. Special ability unlocked. Focus. Press or hold L1. Strike harder, launch enemies into the air, jump higher, and move faster, combining focus with your abilities.
Fight.
Let's try this. Ready? Ow. Ow. I love that they actually use a silly havoc physics for the enemies who you knock down. Alright. Oh shit!
Before the internet, we had armor. This is how people used to fight, and it proves very useful to the user. From a whole sword, it keeps you safe.
As you travel the path of the one and reach higher levels of awareness, you can earn greater levels of focus.
Fight. Excellent.
Don't fall in. Get tossed, jabroni. Bottom of the focus meter holds a reserve focus. Reserve focus regenerates up to a point. Okay. Oh, that's kind of neat. Oh no! Got that fair footwork.
Kill him!
Focus hyperstrike. Okay. Alright. Uh-oh. Yo, you see this guy's jacket? This guy's a problem. Oh shit. Yes. Fuck him up. Get his ass. Tear his ass apart. No!
Neo, pulling you out. Gotta take better care of yourself in there, Neo.
Here, we gotta try that again. You think that's blood you're peeing now? Oh, what the fuck?
Bonus weapons just up ahead.
Oh my god, time bomb. Thank you so much. Time bomb going off. Gifting subs to Mibzy, Astro Goblin, Kiana Guten, Spider Rumor, and let me grab my keys. Thank you. Thank you so kindly. Time bomb. Welcome back. Thank you. Look at that. I completely forgot that I had the twins up on my screen there, which is great.
Ready for the big finale?
Okay, actually, we didn't have to go that far back.
Fight. Owned.
I kind of want to remap the controls. It feels weird not having dodge on a circle. I wonder if it'll let me do that. I mean, I'm sure I can do that through the emulator. Look at Neo's tiny little arms. It's great. Speaking of tiny little arms, I rewatched Sam Raimi's Spider-Man recently. And from a, like, body... I don't want to say body positivity, but, like, a healthy body's standpoint, it was a shocking reminder of how far... we have, how much things have changed, how much our perception of what an insanely jacked guy looks like has changed in recent years in Marvel movies. Because, like, I remember everybody was like, holy shit, Tobey Maguire got so incredibly jacked for Spider-Man, it's insane. And I went back and I watched it, and it's like, yeah, he's in really good shape. He looks like he knows how to do push-ups. Looks like he curls like 20, like he looks a healthy but still impressive kind of jacked, but like compared to how much we expect of our guys getting weirdly jacked for Marvel movies now, it's a completely different thing. What changed? Did diet science change? Or is it just like the expectation of, yeah, them looking like insanely dehydrated? Chris Evans, Captain America. Yeah, that was a Chris Evans. Yeah, that HGH bod. I'm dodging around now. I'm getting the hang of this. I think we've talked about favorite Chris's on the stream before. I think mine was Hemsworth for a while. And I think I've come around to it being Pine. I think Pine is the sleeper Chris. He's the low-key secret best Chris. Let me grab my key, says he's the thinking man's Chris. Chris Lee, that is a very good Chris.
Fight.
Chris Kringle, also okay. So there's no block button. I think I just need to dodge more. Get fucked. Oh shit, you shouldn't be able to do that. Shit. Okay, so I'm supposed to punch him or grab him when he does that. I don't
beat him down, kick his ass.
Trilobite says, this guy's arm thing just makes me think of Ghostface Killah and Def Jam Fight for New York. I watched a really great, it was like one of those like Vanity Fair or like Wirecutter videos where they just like do a deep dive like chat with somebody in front of a white background, but it was just the RZA talking about all of the samples that they pulled talking about his favorite Kung Fu films and how they sampled them for the old Wu-Tang albums. And he knows so much about Shaw Brothers films and just 70s action film in general. It's like historian level knowledge that he'll just like drop. Like he knows like the names of directors and producers and like people who were in this movie and also that movie, and this guy who did the stunt coordination for this movie later starred in this one. It's just really, I want him to just do a podcast or just do a stream where he just talks about old the action movies he loves. Trilobite, I do want to watch the Man with the Iron Fist. Yeah, ETPC says, Shaw Brothers films are either the most hype shit ever or unbelievably boring, and it's great. That's kind of my experience with Hong Kong films in general from, like, the, I'd say, any time between, like, the 70s and mid-90s. Like, the pacing was always just, like, so unpredictable whether or not it was just going to be, like, pure action for the whole time, just, like, mind-blowing action for the whole time, or, like, two or three mind-blowing action sequences just right at the end, and then the movie ends. Like, the first Police Story is, I think, the worst paced of the Police Story films, because it's a couple of really good action scenes and then an insanely long stretch of like hijinks and not stuff that's not boring, but it's not Jackie Chan doing cool shit. All right. Focus, weapon strip, bullet dodge. I mean, that's the whole thing, right? That's the thing that he's known for. Oh, hang on. Okay. Sweet. Okay. Yep. I understand now. Thank you. Thank you for demonstrating. I guess I can't afford any of these things yet. Time Bomb, they're good. You should watch the first one at least. And I'm really not sure what it would be like to watch the second and third ones separated from their historical context and the time that they came out in.
Teleporting looks like so much fun. Wish I could do it.
I definitely recommend watching the Animatrix. There's some incredibly good stuff in there. Who's the guy who did Aeon Flux? Is it Peter Chung? Yeah. His short is pretty good. There's one by the Cowboy Bebop guy that's fun. Alright. Dodge around attacks. Advanced acrobatics. Kazat tips, when I say the context for 2 or 3, I mean the fact that, like, The Matrix just totally came out of nowhere, right? Like, nobody expected it to be a cultural phenomenon and to change, really change the landscape of Hollywood action films, especially for the following decade. So nobody really saw it coming. And then the context for the second two is just that, like, this movie came out of nowhere, and then there's this super, super hotly anticipated sequels that just sort of weirded everybody out. Or both either hyped people the fuck up or weirded them out. If I recall, the reception to the second one, like, people in sort of my age group and sort of social group, I think you really liked the second one because it had a whole bunch of, like, really insane action in it and had, like, a fucking 40-minute chase scene that was really well done. And then the second one had a whole lot of, like, more sort of grounded, reality-based stuff and a whole lot of just metaphysical chit-chat. So I think generally liked it less. But I did enjoy it a lot more as an adult when I rewatched a couple months ago. This sword fighting sucks shit. I hope the new one has a rave too. Seriously, the rave scene in Reloaded aged better. I thought. Dropkick. It is so well done. I feel like it might have been somewhat dethroned by Fury Road in terms of just, like, clarity of purpose and staging of a chase scene. But the part where Morpheus cuts an Escalade's tires off with a samurai sword and then shoots the gas tank with a fully automatic extended mag Glock until it explodes is so hard to beat. Right.
Are you a worthy challenge?
Stun animation is so good.
Watch your health, Neo.
Oh. Grab his ass.
No!
This kind of sucks. Uh-oh.
Trinity. What are you doing here?
Exercise.
This is not your fight.
Looks tough.
My sword will find you.
Let's do it.
Okay.
If either of you fight it, I'm pulling you out.
Use as the enemy strikes to dodge attacks. If you're successful, your foe will be disoriented for a short time. Strike quickly.
This creep isn't going down easy. Dodge his attacks, Neo.
Now, hold on. Man, that grab just vacuums you in.
Neo,
damn.
I'm pulling you out.
You are no challenge.
Is that Jennifer Hale as Trinity? Nice.
Let's run it again.
Yeah, time bomb. They're very good. Oh, we're all the way back here. Okay. And we can't skip this. Okay. Okay. Cool. Cool, cool, cool.
Yee.
Caffeina Felina, thank you for stepping back up. Welcome to the pizza party.
Whoa.
Ta-da. Teleporting looks like so much
fun. That fucking Beavis and Butthead head. Oh yeah, MB. They were super involved in it.
Okay. You ready for some action?
I mean, they were huge fucking nerds. I mean, they, obviously they still are. I don't know why I'm talking in past tense. The Wachowskis live. Spoilers, I don't know if we're gonna play this game all the way through. It ends... this game ends like the film trilogy ends, with Agent Smith and Neo having a final showdown.
Your blade skills are
and they
today you will learn that mine are as well. So,
what are they retcon the ending. They created a new ending specifically for the game, but the ending is introduced by a cutscene of like pixel art versions of the two of them sitting in these chairs saying like, hey, we know the ending that you're about to see is not like the ending of the film, but the ending of the film would be a really bad ending for a video game. So we did this instead. And then all of the Agent Smiths pile into one gigantic pile of man and essentially turn into a gigantic Agent Smith kaiju that Neo has to fight, and it rules.
A lucky strike at your last.
Are there any healing items in this game that I can pick up? Boy, this game is kind of dog shit, isn't it? Didn't Otto, that would not surprise me, but there is that very good tweet of, I think, Lana Wachowski telling Elon Musk to fuck off. Dropkick, I liked Enter the Matrix. And I think I also bought it on launch day. But yeah, I was a child. No, I was an idiot child. I was stupid. Oh, hang on. Libtron said, oh yes, the go fuck yourself tweet. Now, where the fuck is this guy? Also, hello, Libby. I didn't know you were about. Libby, I'm gonna be in a... I what I believe is your neck of the woods for literally one night next week. And I'm gonna be way too busy to go do anything fun in the area. But it's gonna be my first time in DC in over probably 20 years. Now, what's going on here? What? Is this a glitch? Is this one of those glitches in the Matrix? Oh, there he is. It does seem like my health came back, though. Oh, see, I downloaded the Kung Fu Max Payne mod that just put the moveset into the game. So good. Unbelievably good. But I did not get a level pack with it. And then Existence. Yeah, that was the Half-Life mod. That one fucking ruled.
Trinity. What are you doing here?
Yeah, Libby, I'll send you a message.
This is not your fight.
I do think my schedule is literally getting in that night and then prepping for a shoot and shooting and then heading back. But I'll see what my one sheet says.
If either of you bite it, I'm pulling you out.
Yeah, that Max Payne mod ruled. Yeah, and then there was Existence, which was the Half-Life mod. Or sorry, the Half-Life mod that was like very, very Matrix themed. And it was like the asymmetrical multiplayer one. And then there was the Specialists. The Specialists was like it wasn't it was Matrix inspired, but it was also just like inspired by like all of like the John Woo and like Hong Kong stuff that was making its way over the audience, over to the Western audiences in like the late 90s and early 2000s. And the Specialists was just like, it was like a deathmatch Half-Life mod, and all the levels were like based on levels from like Face Off and the Matrix, but it had really, really, really good acrobatics and for the time, a really fun hand-to-hand combat system. You could play it in first-person or third-person shooter mode. And it also had, like... I don't know how they modded this into the Half-Life engine, but it had, like, working, like, slow-mo. I don't remember if it was, like, line-of-sight... It wasn't line-of-sight-based slow-mo, because that's the solution they came up with for Max Payne 3's multiplayer. I think it was just, like, sphere-of-influence slow-mo, where, like, within a certain range around a character who would activate the slow-mo... And just a certain sphere, everybody would slow down.
This creek isn't going down easy. Dodge his attacks, Neo.
Dodge his attacks, Neo. I have thought in the past about seeing if I could find a way to play the Specialists on stream if it's still running. Or if anybody's still running servers for it. I'm sure I'd get absolutely wrecked just because if anybody's still playing it, they've probably been playing it for 20 years. Still popping? Oh, sick. Okay. I will, I'm guessing I can probably, like, get it on Steam or something. Or pick up the original Half-Life on Steam and get the mod. A lot of RP servers. I mean, listen, I'm okay bowing before I fight. Did my sword break? Blade anymore, dude. I dropped it.
Are you a worthy challenge? What you cannot see, you cannot hit.
No, I gotta do three of them. Jesus Christ, I don't have a fucking sword anymore. Hang on, did I stow my sword? Cool sword flash attack. Get out of there, homie. What, they can just fucking teleport? Nah, give me that sword. There we go. Who's next? Bye, Time Bomb. Thanks for dropping by. We'll catch you on the next one.
Where'd he go?
Stay still.
Ah.
can't see.
Tell you what, now that I have this PlayStation emulator set up, though, I have been thinking I would love to download Tenchu 2. Get a little Tenchu action going. Yeah, I fucking know, okay? What was the other good shit on PS2? What's other good PS2 shit I should get? Guitar Hero 3. Yeah, absolutely won't get DMCA'd for that. It'll be very fun to play on my Xbox 360 controller. Spider-Man 2 is a fun game. Oh yeah, I think Tekken 5, up to Tekken 5 was on here.
Thanks for the practice.
Don't mention it.
Keep your blade sharp, Neo.
What kind of beans, Meme Shart? Bean Shart. Warriors is a very fun game, yep. So I've unlocked the 4-hit combo. Code Vision. God, look at all these... Man, look at all these things that you unlock. Neil's gonna get strong! This game must have the Burly Brawl in it. The scene where he fights like 100 Agent Smiths. Hybrid Heaven. I should play Hybrid Heaven sometime. I don't think that was a PS2 game though, right? I think it was like N64. Boy, they just keep doing this shit. Okay. Oh, I gotta use a sword, I guess. Yeah. The Bouncer, that would be sick. What was that Namco Bandai game that had some Tekken characters in it? It was like a brawler with like Tekken characters in it. There was Nina Death by Degrees, that one was really bad. But then there was The Simpsons, you're right. Self, okay, I am going to download a, I'm going to legally acquire, I'm going to legally acquire Simpsons Road Rage. Hit and Run, there was a Crazy Taxi one and a GTA one. Apparently the wrestling one is terrible. Yeah, I did not have the GTA, the Simpsons GTA one, but I had the Simpsons the Simpsons Crazy Taxi game, and I loved it. Time Splitters 2, also a fantastic game. Future Perfect, I don't remember liking as much as Time Splitters 2. But I enjoyed those games a lot.
Uh-oh!
Useful.
Oh shit, my legs.
I was watching a Tom Walker stream the other day, and he's downloaded the Jackass game. So I'm not gonna bite Tom Walker's stream plans and also get the Jackass game, but I might get it for personal use. Happy Earmuffs. The reason is because the Wachowskis are huge weebs. Focus link up attacks. Use L1 at the start of multi-person link up attack to unleash devastating attacks. You know I'm never going to do that. Taking a coconut. I used to love Agent Under Fire. Maybe it was Nightfire. Maybe that was the one that I had. The one that I had was on GameCube. And I was like, finally, a worthy successor to GoldenEye! It was not. I was just so desperate for something to be a little bit like GoldenEye that I was willing to accept it. Just stacking swords here. And B-Brit, thank you for stepping up. Welcome to the pizza party. You're right, Perfect Dark was the successor. I never owned Perfect Dark because it was rated M. Right? Wasn't that one rated M? I will say, imagine buying this Matrix video game in like 2004, 2005, whenever it came out, and being like, right? Like, I feel like I'm okay with the fact that this is what the Matrix video game is, because it's been so fucking long since this anybody was like super organic. Since we were in the midst of the Matrix fury, the Matrix mania. But imagine buying a Matrix game and then it's this. It's like 3 hours of running around in dojos. Dire Sloth, I think it was bloodier. I think there was like blood in Perfect Dark. More blood than there was in GoldenEye. Now, Memeshare, I don't know if I remember that. I don't remember. I think I would, if I had Nightfire, I think I would remember looking at people's underwear. So maybe I played Agent Under Fire.
Yo, watch out. This place is starting to fall apart.
Alright, let's try this killing blow. Alright, that was pretty cool. Sekiro is so... you're just making me wish I was playing Sekiro, Meme Shark. Also, I have been playing a whole lot of Ghost of Tsushima in my relaxation time, and this is gonna really fuck up my muscle memory for that.
Sorry about that, Neo. Everything's under control now.
I'm gonna be in a rough place next time I boot that up.
As you can see, this program was designed for multiple opponent combat training. Cypher didn't think he would make it through the burning hall. Well done.
God damn you,
now,
Cypher.
Focus. Here comes the final.
Hey, Jimmy. Yeah, there are definitely similarities in the feel of the combat system. I feel like the Arkham one was way snappier than this. Keanu is just whiffing those attacks in this one. What's up, fucker? This is a like, I guess credit for like trying to do something interesting with this combat system here, but it is not working. It says circle towards one, circle towards another. Alright, that's just a judo throw. That was really funny how he just did that little spin step. Now give me that sword. Give me that sword. We did it. I'm never gonna do that death blow again, Meme Shark. I've already forgotten it. I know how to do it.
My friend, you are a natural.
Get fucked, losers. fire exploded. Yeah, it just absolutely keeps going forever and ever. Okay, hyper strike. On stunned enemies? I don't know how to stun an enemy. Do I look like a fucking genius to you? Alright, death blow. Death blow. Totally legible. Love to see that. Give me a sword. Give me a freaking sword. Okay, here we go. No checkpoint for a while, chat. Oh boy, it's been a while since the last checkpoint. Yeah. Oh shit, I need to watch the new God of War trailer. I have not watched any of the stuff that came out of that Sony thing earlier.
Your health is low. Do you have any potions?
You really got me there, Tub. Conway, the controls are the thing that do not hold up, I'd say, the most. More than anything.
Excellent swordplay, Neil. With a focus
KOTOR on remake, sick.
Can stand between you and the path you choose. Let's load up the time trial.
I should probably stop soon and eat some dinner. I just had a bunch of bread for dinner. Or before my stream. It's a bunch of bread. It's a box of balloons. It's a box of balloons. I want to see if we can get out of our training here, though. I would love to get beyond the training phase of this game. All right, I've unlocked what I unlocked now. Killing blow. Okay. No, still doing this dojo shit, I guess. Mario wears out tomorrow. You're right. Super excited for that. I have that pre-ordered. Oh, holy shit, Hatchet Gang shit. Alright, let's attempt a killing blow.
You get bonus points for each wave defeated. Think you can get the record?
Think you can get the record? I haven't seen Shang-Chi yet. Floppy body sliding down the stairs is really good.
Adding a new enemy type. He's upgraded with a ranged attack.
Uh-oh. Alright, target enemy, hold run. Oh, I did, for the whole time I did not know that was possible. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Throw it. Oh, you gotta hold it. It just bounced off of him. Okay, I've learned how to draw weapons. Fuck him up. Fuck him up. Take that, Morpheus. Oh, shit! Yeah, stick the axe into his chest like a sword. This guy's a real gamer, Morpheus. Alright, that was pretty sick.
Incredible! Your
Oh, I just fucked up those stairs. That was sick.
Plop, just like a ball.
We did it. Music is really weird, isn't it? Jesus Christ, they're still going. This is literally the exact restaurant layout from Hard Boiled. So they're going to do, we're going to do a shooting thing now. Yeah, this is Hard Boiled. Hard Boiled is really, really, really good. Existence, wait, the Cronenberg one or the Half-Life mod? Okay. Farms, unlimited ammo, upgrade them as you master each type. Okay.
About to have no choice.
Good one, Meme Shark.
So you don't go getting all fancy with your kung fu. I'm taking away your ability to fight hand to hand.
Eat hot lead, you piece of trash.
Remember to focus, Neo. Your shots become more accurate.
Okay, fine.
Watch out, Neo. The boss is on to you.
Okay, fine, Jesus Christ. The shooting sucks.
Boss, Neo.
Did I just get a second pistol?
These people need
Right, during a link up, around a corner, step into the open, and tip up or around the corner, step into the open, press R1 to fire. Okay, yeah, I thought I was doing that. Roll out. I'm linked up to a wall. Press X to cartwheel out into the open. Careful. Press R1 to fire.
Enemy could be waiting for you around any and every corner.
Oh, would you look at that?
Try more aerial targeting. Use wall runs and jumps to catch big air, target an enemy, then fire away.
Okay.
Not only does it make you hard to hit, but it looks cool.
I hear that, man. These controls are fucking impossible. I'm holding like 8 bullets. I'm holding like so many buttons down right now. Yeah, hang on. Let me talk y'all through this. Okay, so to take out your guns, you hit R. To shoot, you hit R1. To jump, we hit A or X. But to do a slow-mo jump, we gotta hold R while we're holding L1. No, we gotta hold R to keep our guns out, and then we gotta hit L1 and X at the same time, and then okay, I think eventually I could probably figure this out. Oh, what's up, Blake? Yeah, we're playing Max Payne. Weapon drawn, use L1 to search and target lock on objects, okay. Nope. Okay, over here, do this. All right, ready? Here we go. We're gonna jump through there and we're gonna shoot this guy. So how we're gonna do that? It's gonna press this to take my guns out. We're gonna run. We're gonna go. Boop. There we go. Target his ass. Oh fuck. Try a wall run.
That's the guy you want to go after. He's your ticket out of the simulation. But you're gonna have to get past his bodyguards.
Blake, this is Neo's training. At this point, this particular point is Neo's training. Yeah, SMG. Here we go. Okay, there's somebody up there, I see.
Okay. way. Hurry, Neo!
.180 targeting, yeah. Thank you.
Oh!
Get his ass. Get his ass.
Awesome. Man, you're really getting good at this. Okay, Morpheus would like to see you now. I think he has something special planned.
He's gonna give me a little kiss.
Neil, I'm going to give you a little kiss.
Is this game just Keanu learning how to do all the things that he does in all the Matrix movies? Like, is that just the game? Is the game just tutorials? Shrek says it does follow all three movies with some additional content and changes. Okay. All right. I'm getting my ass kicked by Lawrence Fishburne. Dream come true. Oh, Jesus Christ, I don't know how to deal with that. It's sick as hell, but unfortunately, I don't know how to stop it from happening. Alright, that was sick. What was that? Jillian, thank you for stopping back up.
Come on, stop trying to hit me and hit me.
Stop trying to hit me and hit me. The edit there, just, this is the sparring program. Okay. Very good. Very, very good. Yeah, study the enemy when he attacks. What? What do I do when he attacks?
to hit me and hit me.
Sweeney, thank you for stepping up. Welcome to Pizza Party. Alright, what the frick do I do here?
Come on. Stop trying to hit me and hit me.
That's the thing that I say. So when I dodge around him there, I should go for a grab. I'm kicking the shit out of Orpheus. Oh, there's weapons. Hang on. Let's run for one. There we go. The part in the actual movie when Morpheus does the Ali shuffle with his legs, like, it's so good. Like, Lawrence Fishburne's footwork was legitimately so gorgeous. All right, focus meter extended. I would love to see Morpheus do this to Neo in the film. Oh shit. I wonder if there's any healing items for us around here. Run around real quick. Scoot around. Oh no! Fuck!
Stop trying to hit me and hit me.
Thank you. off the wall attacks. What are those? How do I do an off the wall attack?
Come on. Stop trying to hit me and hit me.
It would be really funny if he just said, okay, when Neo told him he knew Kung Fu. Yeah, and? What do you want me to do about it? Alrighty, let's try this again.
Come on, stop trying to hit me and hit me.
Let's try this again. Alright, here we go. Ready? Here we go. Nope.
Come on. Stop trying to hit me and hit me.
Yeah, really good. Real good. Just fuck this wall. Hey, fuck this wall. This game's really good. I'm having a good time with this game. Except for WarioWare tomorrow.
Stop trying to hit me and hit me. Come on. Stop trying to hit me and hit me. Come on. Come on.
All right, gang. We're done for the day. Thank you, everybody, for dropping by. Duke Nukem in the Matrix. See, now you are on the cutting edge of comedy, Meme Shark. Yeah, thank you, everybody, for dropping by this Matrix stream. Maybe we'll continue playing the Matrix game. Maybe we won't. It's been fun. I do now have the option to play some more PS2 classics, so I might put a couple of those on the horizon. Maybe I'll see if I can get fucking King's Road on here. No, what's it called? King's what's the old FromSoft game? Kingsfield. There we go. The King's Speech. Hassan, but more attractive. Gifted a sub to Tom Walker. Thank you so much. Is Tom here, or is that just a courtesy to Tom Walker? Either way, if you're here, Tom, hello. If you're not, bye. no, thank you for that, Hassan. Oh, thank you. Very kind, Hassan. Thank you for your gen of Rossity. Tom's not here right now. No, I haven't seen Tom about. King's Cup. What did I promise you and Mike? And what did I promise you and Mike? The Simpsons. The Simpsons. Yeah, we'll get the Simpsons. We'll get the Simpsons going. Home of Simpson. How much, I don't know. How much is that going to change my life, that game? Monster Rancher 3, that sounds good. I am excited to play Hit and Run. I think Hit and Run's going to be fun. Only Marge voice. I can't do... We have... Many, many months ago, here on the stream, we learned what happens when I try to do Marge voice. It doesn't work. It's not good for me or anyone. Hello, Venom. I've been trying to figure out, because the Go Off Kings, they do Marge mode now, where they do the Marge voice. And the clip of me trying to figure out if I could do Marge voice from earlier this year, the clip is entitled Marge Mode. And I don't know if it was clipped that and named that after the Kings invented Marge Mode, or if somebody who clips stuff on my channel predicted Marge Mode before it happened. Did I invent Marge mode? I pioneered Marge. I invented doing the Marge Simpson voice. Julie Kavner can get fucked. I invented trying to talk like Marge. One day, Julie Kavner had the idea. She said, I'm going to try to talk like Marge. Today, I will try to talk like Marge Simpson. That's what she said before she got in the booth. I guess I'm really tired because none of the shit is funny or makes sense, but we're going to call it a night. Good night, everybody. Thank you so much. We'll be back on Sunday. Everybody go check out Blake's stream tomorrow at 7:30. Thank you to Sylph and Mike, as always, for helping out and modding. And yeah, I'll be back Sunday with either some more PS2, maybe a little hit and run, maybe a little Simpsons, maybe a little Dark Souls. Just Sylph tonight. Well, thank you, Sylph. And yeah, we're going to call it. I'm going to send y'all over to Herney. Herney's playing a game that I'm interested in learning more about. Tales of Arise. Never played it myself. Looks kind of cool. So yeah, have fun. And say hi for me. We'll see y'all soon. Bye.